believe that Leon never mentioned that he knew you. I mean, you'd think that it would come up. I'd mention you if I knew you. I so loved you in The Greatest American Hero. I'm going to stop now before I become truly unbearable.
Is it Yola?
Yola.
I doubt that you could ever be unbearable, Yola.
Oh. Well, how long are you shooting here?
I think it's 8 weeks.
Wow. Well, there are so many fantastic things to see around the Bay Area. I should make you a list.
Is there any chance that you're free to show me yourself?
Show you myself, as in...
As in dinner tomorrow night.
Dinner?
Of course, if you're busy tomorrow...
No, I'm not busy. I would love to.
Well, that's wonderful. I'll call you tomorrow.
Okay, well, I'll talk to you tomorrow, Mr. Culp.
Bob, Robert, or hey you, anything but Bobby.
Okay. Bob.
Tomorrow.
Good.
Was that Robert Culp?
Bob.
I'm the original American boy.
Did you walk Daisy? Well, she has to be walked, Tyler. That means actually turning off the computer and going outside, okay? Okay? Okay, I'll see you soon, honey.
Everything's okay?
Everything's always okay. I never have to worry where my son is.
That's a good thing, right?
Didn't you go out and play when you were a kid? Raise a little hell?
No, I was too busy with charity work, giving puppet shows at the orphanage.
Indoor mushroom kid. It can't be healthy.
You know what we used to go run around? Playland, the little amusement park over by you. I had cousins who lived next to it. We'd go over there in the summer and smash into each other in the bumper cars, and we mess with the flying swings to where they really flew.
See, now that seems like normal boy stuff.
Oh, it was great. It was all lit up at night. They played this loud tinny music. These mean-looking city girls would come out and walk around smoking and cussing, looking all sophisticated. That was an excellent place for kids.
I wish they still had places like that.
Oh, Playland's still around. Tyler could walk over from your place.
Right, not. It's closed.
You're kidding me.
No, they closed it. I think they're going to tear it down.
That's terrible.
Oh, no. What can we accomplish in half an hour?
How can they tear down Playland?
Welcome, boys and girls! Welcome!
Huh?
It's really creepy, Chris.
Creepy? Come on!
Welcome, boys and girls!
It's filled with a clown welcoming us to Playland!
I'm not kidding. Turn it off.
Okay. Best stuff's inside anyway. Come on.
Okay.
This is my favorite ride. Let me tell you something, though. This is definitely a pre-lunch ride because post-lunch will get you in a lot of trouble.
Good to know.
Yeah, I used to come out here when I was 10 years old, sucking up the snow cones, chasing girls. Of course, I didn't know why then. Hey, that's Mr. Furnell. He was a caretaker when I was a kid. Hey, Mr. Furnell!
Hey, Opie, why don't you tell me why we're really here? Because you got that look in your eyes that you get when you have really bad ideas.
It's not a bad idea. The place is for sale, and I've been considering...
Oh, my God.
It's not that crazy of an idea. Dolly Parton's got Dollywood. Michael Jackson has Neverland. Although that's more of a personal quirk than a family fun park.
Chris, this isn't a new shirt. This isn't a new guitar. This is a big old rusty money pit that should be torn down and sold for scrap metal.
How can you say that? When now more than ever, kids need a place like this. They're all sitting parked in front of their computers turned into slugs.
I mean, doesn't your new girlfriend have a kid?
Yeah, but this isn't about that.
Good. Good, because that would be insane to be spending thousands of dollars on a headache that you don't know how to run just to impress a woman.
I agree, but this isn't about that. This is about preserving something that should be preserved.
Like?
Like the great American tradition of eating cotton candy and puking on the tilt-a-whirl. Yola, look, I'm finally taller than Sam the Prospector. I can't let Playland close now. Huh?
Playland. That crappy little amusement park with the twirling teacups and bad corn dogs?
Hey, it won't be crappy by the time it's transformed into Isaakland.
Oh my God, you're really buying Playland. That's fucking incredible.
See, Anson's on board.
I don't know. I think you're losing it.
Yeah, you're not expecting us to play this joint, are you? Surely this is a quiet little mistake that we don't have to participate in.
Opening day's in 2 weeks. We're going to do a set.
Hey, look, you're going to own Thor's Hammer and the Drop Zone and Alibaba.
Oh, man, Alibaba!
I think it's cool Chris putting his name on a nice, wholesome family place.
Thank you, Herschel.
Hey, Chris, can I get it past all the rides? I mean, I think I deserve that as a loyal band member. I'll pay for all my own food, but, you know, if you want to throw that in, too, that'd be pretty cool.
Okay, Anson, you can have a pass to the rides.
I don't know. My grandpa did weird shit like this, you know, right before we took his credit cards away from him.
Start the song.
You've been telling everybody how much you love me, but I don't know. I don't know. And you put your arms around me. Tell me that you need me. Is it so? Baby, is it so?
So besides TV and movies, I read that you did regional theater and Broadway. What a career.
Well, I had a good run.
Yeah. I'm going to rent Bob, Ted, Carol, and Alice. Because I haven't seen it yet. I mean, it wasn't intentional. I just think it was about one. Is that weird?
No, not for me.
To me either.
Okay.
Yeah. I did see you in Pelican Brief, though. I think you were wonderful.
Thank you. So, I think dinner went pretty well, don't you?
Yes. Oh, my gosh, I can't believe it's so late. Thank you.
Where next?
Next? Aren't you? You've been shooting all day.
Oh, darling, I'm just getting warmed up.
So glad you could stay on as a caretaker, Mr. Furnell.
Oh, Fletcher. Nobody calls me Mr. Furnell.
Fletcher. Anyway, I didn't really want to make that many changes, but I was kind of thinking about some of the novelty acts you used to have, like I didn't see the spot for the Dancing Chicken.
Oh, yeah, Huey.
Right, Huey, the Dancing Chicken. How did you get him to dance like that?
Hot plate.
Excuse me?
He was standing on a hot plate. We had to keep turning up the heat to keep him dancing. Went through about 13 Hueys.
Huh. Maybe we'll skip that. The guys with the canaries. Those are always so exotic looking.
Pain in the ass. I ain't painting any more birds.
They were painted?
Sparrows, yeah. We painted them, but they pecked the hell out of my hands. I don't want to do that anymore.
Yeah, maybe not.
Of course, that stuff was nothing compared to the shows we used to do in the old days. I mean, we had the Lobster Boy, Mule-Faced Woman, and Esther Lester.
Esther Lester.
Half man, half woman. For an extra $5, he could watch him do himself.
Maybe we'll just stick with the regular games and rides. Wow, who did all this?
Bob!
Bob, you mean Robert Culp? Are you guys going out?
Uh-huh.
Really? Isn't he a little,
What, old? No, he's not too old. Believe me, he's not too old for anybody. He has incredible energy.
Oh, really?
No, not oh, really. We've had one great date.
I know that's probably very, very hard for you to understand, a man making such a lovely gesture to a woman who he's not sleeping with, but that's what a mature man does. A man with experience who deeply understands the male-female dynamic. He's a gentleman.
Huh.
Yeah, he's thoughtful, and he opens my door for me, and he helps me on with my coat. I mean, honestly, would you ever even think to do little things like that?
No. I did when I was 18, because I'd seen it in movies, but women looked at me like I was nuts. See, the women I hang out with kind of like to put on their own coats and open their own doors.
But did you come in here for some reason?
Just to see the flowers. Actually, Tyler, as of today, it's no longer Playland. It's...
Welcome, boys and girls! Welcome!
You like it?
Well, I figured now it's Isaakland, you'd want your own mug up there. Couldn't do anything about the boots, though. They're bolted down.
It's great.
Hi.
This is Tyler.
Hey, Tyler. You excited about the opening of Isaakland? Yeah, I know what you mean.
Isn't this great? This is a place where people can bring their kids for a good time. It's a good old-fashioned, friendly, family amusement park. Where kids can really...
I don't want to Papa.
Where kids can really have... fun.
You gotta practice like a mother. You gotta practice really hard and have a natural ability for it, which I do.
You work for the guy with the hair, right?
Yeah.
Is he a dick?
No, man. Hey, check it out. He gave me this pass.
Whoa, nice.
Yeah, it's for all the rides.
Oh, sweet.
Awesome.
So you having a good time?
Definitely. This was a wonderful thing to do, Chris.
Yeah, it kind of was, wasn't it? But you know, it won't be completely wonderful unless you go home with a large stuffed tiger. And I think I'll give it a try. Sir, if you please.
There you go, sir.
You ready to roll out the prizes? Just warming up. You ain't seen nothing yet.
That's the only way it is.
You know, I was never really a softball guy. I was kind of busy with band practice.
Good to see you, sir.
Special owner's balls. Give it a try.
Yeah, thanks.
Guess you're a softball guy after all.
Yeah, I guess.
You see, there's a small pellet on one side. I gotta tell you, it's a real art to weight these balls.
It's dishonest.
What's your point, Jake?
I'm Chris.
Well, Chris isn't Carney, Jake is.
Yeah, well, I guess the point is, I want to run an honest amusement park.
Well, you can do that.
Good.
For about a week. See, if you, how can I put this, if you make the games honest, well, then you're going to have prizes flying out your ass and you're going to lose on them. Now, as for the food, see, you pay off the food inspector, it's a one-time deal. But if you're actually going to try and sell fresh food, well, that's going to cost you.
The food's not fresh?
Well, let's just say you should stick with the prepackaged items.
Okay, that's unacceptable. We're going to have healthy food and honest games at Isaakland.
You say so. I mean, you're the boss. Still going to pay off the riot, Inspector, though. That's just common sense.
No, I want an honest assessment of the riots. They're safe, aren't they?
Oh, sure they are. I check those myself. But people do stupid things. So you post the rules. If somebody loses a head, you blame that on horseplay.
I want the riots checked and rechecked. Fresh food, honest games, safe rides.
Okay, you're gonna lose your shirt, Jake.
Yola? Yola?
What? Hi. Hi. Hi, what do you want?
Were you sleeping?
No, no. I was just, meditating.
Oh, yeah? Another late night?
No, no, not necessarily. Just, another wonderful, stimulating, somewhat lengthy night with, Bob.
You and Robert Culp, who would have thought?
Yeah, well, the age difference is, not an issue. That guy is a powerhouse of verve. I mean, seriously, it's almost overwhelming. I mean, it's not. I mean, I'm not overwhelmed.
Well, good.
Yeah. Yeah, dating an older man is like walking into this amazing house that's filled with all this interesting stuff. You never get bored. By comparison, younger guys are... I mean, there's no comparison.
Well, that's great.
Yeah. Yeah, and they know how to treat women. You know, like ladies, not like some hot package of body parts.
So you guys really like each other?
Yes, of course we like each other. Why would we be dating each other if we didn't like each other?
Well, listen, I mean, I can see that this is for real. Some people might jump to certain conclusions, assume that it's the old cliche, but it's not fair and it's not right.
What old cliche? What?
You know, younger woman selling her youth and beauty for security and a certain sense of reflected fame, but obviously that's not the case with you guys. So I support that. Hey, I got a question for you. This counterpart clause on Jade's contract, shouldn't that indicate an agreement be executed by two or more counterparts or by different parties on separate counterparts?
I'll look it over.
Okay, great.
Okay.
And this is where we hang out before the shows.
Whoa. Nice.
Yeah, we get free snacks.
Free snacks?
What kind of snacks?
We got potato chips, pretzels, goldfish, Hershey Kisses, and sometimes Fritos. Oh, this is Kenny. Yeah, he's cool.
What's up, man?
Hey, not much. It's good to talk to you, huh? What is this, a field trip or something? Hey, watch it. Watch it here.
Oh, they wanted to see the club, except they can't come at night because they're bedtime, so.
Tell you what, why don't you guys scoot for a minute and let me have a little talk with your bud Anson here. What do you say?
Gotta split anyways. Dinner.
All right, catch you later.
See you.
See you, man.
Yo.
See you. Later.
See you later.
That's great.
Word up.
See you, Anson.
What are you doing?
What?
Hanging out with these kids.
Oh, it's all right. They're cool.
Well, it's borderline creepy and you look ridiculous.
Hey, man, they're into some excellent stuff. Like Sean, he read a book on China, and Tyler, he can burp that Nelly Furtado song.
Oh, that is impressive. And I'm sure it's a real meeting of the minds, and oh, they happen to just ooh and all over every dumbass thing you do.
Yeah, so?
And you like that.
Like what?
People looking up to you, even though they are pre-adolescent and don't know any better.
Hey, man, they respect me.
Well, if they do, it's because you can shave. I mean, you're a grown man, for Christ's sake. At least you're supposed to be. Hanging out with these kids is just stupid.
Well, Yola's dating Robert Culp, who's a lot older, and no one thinks that's stupid. Ha! Got you there.
Anson, I'm sure that basing your self-worth on what a bunch of 12-year-olds think is nothing short of pathetic.
Yeah, well, one man's pathetic is another man's not pathetic.
Actually, in many ways, that makes perfect sense.
See?
So from now on, it's gonna be a clean show. Like, for starters, I've ordered normal softballs and fresh food. Any questions? Yeah.
With all due respect, Mr. Isley.
Isaak.
I think you're screwing yourself.
How so?
Well, you make the games honest, and there's no challenge.
Sure there is. Their honest game's a skill.
Excuse me for saying so, but anyone who can't throw a normal softball into a clown's mouth from 12 feet is a shameful pussy. But a guy who can figure out how he fucked with a ball, still get it in, that guy deserves to stop paying pounds.
Look, hey, this is a family place. So what kind of a message are we sending the kids if the games aren't honest?
Goddamn do-gooders. This is Florida all over again.
Florida?
People like you decided dwarf tossing was demeaning, so they outlawed it.
Well, I'm sorry if it didn't work out for you.
Easy for you, Fabian. What would you know about downsizing?
I'm not downsizing you. I'm actually upsizing you to a better workplace.
Bullshit.
Not that bigger means better in any way. Look, I know it's a different way of doing things, but I really think that this is the way to go. So tomorrow we start, okay? Yeah.
We're still gonna drug the pony ride ponies, though, aren't we? Because if you don't, they get mean.
It's just not what I pictured, you know? Thought I'd be strolling around Isaakland, riding the tilt-a-whirl, making cotton candy for the kids.
Willy Wonka?
Yeah, kind of a Steve McQueen Willy Wonka. Who would ever thought there was such a dark underbelly in the amusement park business?
Vegas.
Great. I start off to be Walt Disney, I end up drugging ponies. Why can't Playland be the way it used to be?
You mean when you were a child?
Exactly. That's the way I want it to be, the way it was when I was a child. I get it. Maybe it never really was that way. Maybe I was just a kid flying on Pez and cotton candy, and it only seemed like a wonderful place. But you know what? It doesn't really matter. Because even if that's just the way I thought it was, I'm still gonna make it the way it should have been. You should come over. Ride the merry-go-round.
Someone.
Robert Culp. Hey, it's an honor.
It is for me. I love your music.
I know all your stuff. I mean, Skyriders, Big Mama 2.
Really?
And all the TV stuff, of course. You know, the one where you're wearing the trench coat and you talk right into the camera. What's that?
Unsolved Mysteries.
Yeah.
That's Robert Stack.
Perfect. You have a show to do, so...
It's still a great pleasure.
Likewise.
I spy.
Right.
I spy. You were that one.
I'll be silent. I'll be strong. I'll wait for you to come to me. I know.
This is so freaking awesome. Check it out. When Triple H spits, you can actually see the water.
And when the blood stains before, it stays or it doesn't disappear.
Promo would never let me have this. You're so lucky. You can play anytime you want.
Yeah. Oh, here. Pause it. Hang on.
Hey.
Tanya, come on in. Hey.
I was just in the neighborhood and I thought... Oh. Are you babysitting?
Huh? Oh, no, these are friends of mine. Yeah, do you want an orange soda?
That's okay. I sort of thought it would just be you and me.
Oh, well... They probably won't be staked too much longer.
That's okay. I'll call you.
Huh? What? Wait a second. Hey, are you sure? Because...
Good riddance. What'd she want anyway?
Well, she wanted me to, Never mind. You guys will understand when you're older.
I hate it when my mom says that.
It's been the most amazing thing. He's playing outside. And he's made new friends, all thanks to you.
We aim to please at Isaakland.
And I don't have to worry about dropping him off there, because I know there'll be a responsible adult around.
There's adults around.
And it frees up time for Mommy.
That's a win-win situation. Are you a jalapeno girl? Because nachos de Isaak are very hot.
Definitely.
Isaak. Well, don't we have any more? I thought we had two cases of Scooby-Doos. Oh, no. Well, I guess you'll just have to shut him down. Can't you handle this, Fletcher? No. No, you can't just kick them out. They've already paid admission. Yeah, I'm coming down there. Yeah.
Problems?
No, they ran out of prizes. And also had to shut down all the rides. I'll be right back. In the meantime, you stay very hot like the jalapenos. Adios. 350 degrees for 10 minutes.
I told you. If you make the games legal, people are going to win them. We've been hemorrhaging Pink Panthers and Tweety Birds all day long.
Well, what about the ride inspector? Is he still here?
No. As soon as he found out he wasn't getting any shekels, he slapped up a ride closed sign and he took off.
He wanted a bribe?
Like I told you, Jake.
That's illegal.
You talk legal to that sweaty bastard.
Bert, where are you going? Is your shift over?
It's a disgrace, that's what it is.
What?
To my profession and the whole carny tradition.
How can it be a disgrace? You're running an honest game. Come on.
Well, I could round up some illegals to run the games for you. They don't speak English, but they don't cost much.
No, I don't think so. But I got a free pass.
Anson! Check it out!
Major score!
Cool, what is it?
There's some kind of problem going on, so no one's paying attention.
We got ourselves a discount.
Discount on candy? That's excellent.
Dude, get a clue. We lifted it.
What? You stole this?
You got optimized? I didn't see them.
The guy must have been brain damaged. He took out his stuff.
Hey. No. Hey, you guys. You can't just steal stuff. It's not good. I mean, I know it's fun, whatever, to score free shit, but Chris runs this place, so you're stealing from him. Besides, stealing is just not right.
You sound like my mom.
Hey, man. I'm not your mom. I'm in a band, and I watch wrestling.
Hey, you want to trade me something for my hot dog?
Yeah.
Well, congratulations. You're a winner. We're out of the bigger prizes, but, how about a keychain? Huh?
I'm sorry, we're done.
That's real leather. Huh?
What a chip.
Hey, there you are. Hi, what's the big emergency?
No big emergency.
Oh, because you canceled a label meeting. There should be a big emergency.
He had a little management snag, but I'm working it out.
Oh, he's hanging at the Lucky Duck.
Yeah, I'm filling in here for a little while. What? What's that look mean?
Well, I'm not gonna stoop to the I told you so. So can you read it by the look instead?
You know, I think that's unfair because I think we're a little too soon for I told you so.
Oh, really? Hey, here's your fucking keychain.
Oh. Well, we're almost there.
Ow.
You okay?
Yeah. I played softball with Bob this weekend. It was so great.
Huh.
And tennis, and we played this game in the pool with his little net, and feel so healthy with him. It's so great.
Good for you.
Need an aspirin. So is everything okay here? Because you know this is insane.
Oh yeah, everything's fine. It's a little crazy right now, but I got it under control. Hey, cough drops. That could make a nice prize.
Nice try.
I can't believe how expensive these little stuffed prizes are.
Where are you getting them from? Maybe you should get something cheap from Japan.
Are you kidding me? Hello Kitty, Pokemon, that's the good stuff. I can't even touch Pikachu and the gang.
Hey, you know what? I have an uncle in Texas. He has a souvenir shop. He can set you up with some of them banjo-playing frogs. Those are damn cute.
Yeah?
Of course, they start to smell in a couple of weeks, but hey, they're out of your hands by then.
Isaak. Hey, Gretchen. Sorry about tonight. I kind of got swamped by Isaakland stuff. Right, again. I can make it up this weekend. Okay. What? No, I didn't get Tyler any free candy. Maybe Anson did. Yeah, sorry. I'll talk to him. I'll tell him not to do that. Okay, can't wait to see you. Bye.
I'll tell you what you need to do with that Isaakland. You're insured, right? My uncle does it every couple of years. He calls it, what's that? Inventory clearance.
Jim, I like to work out early. You sleep.
What? I didn't even hear you come in last night. Did you get sleep?
Well, sure. I got a couple hours. I'm fine. I'll see you for breakfast.
Bye.
Welcome, boys and girls.
Hey.
Welcome.
What's going on?
We rigged up this cool...
Shut up! He'll tell.
I'm not gonna tell. What are you doing? Hey, what's with the hose?
You ready?
Welcome, boys and girls!
No,
welcome.
Really, guys, what's going on?
Just chill, all right?
This looks kind of dangerous.
It's not dangerous, you wuss.
Hey, I'm not a wuss.
Okay, let's do it. Five, four, three,
two, one. Wait, no!
It's just a prank. It's not like anybody got hurt.
Yep, and I can't believe that you're part of this. I wasn't. I tried to stop it. Well, you know, we're gonna have to call your mom.
My mom?
Not your mom, his mom.
Whatever.
How'd you guys rig that up exactly?
With a hydraulic pump.
Pretty clever.
All right, that's it. You're writing down your names, and I'm calling your moms. Can't believe I heard myself say that.
Dark.
Dweeb.
Lovely. Just lovely.
Well, it's time to face facts, Jake.
You know, I really don't care for that nickname, Jake.
You're just not carny.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. Oh, ow, ow.
Girl, you work too hard.
I know. Thanks.
Fortunately, God did invent the weekend, and I do have a plan for this one.
Oh?
Mm-hmm. My place at Tahoe. I want you to see it.
Oh, wow, that sounds so neat.
I just got a new jet ski. We can take that out Saturday. And there's this great little joint right off the lake for salsa dancing later.
Salsa dancing? Wow, that sounds great. Do you think maybe we could stay in and sit by the fire and have some wine, maybe relax?
Trust me, we'll have time for that too. Oh, you like horses? Horseback riding?
Horseback riding.
Uh-huh. There's a stables right near the house.
I can't do this. I can't do this. I can't do this, Bob.
What?
I like you so much. I love the way that you make me feel. You make me feel great. You make me feel like a lady, like a goddess. And no one I've ever dated has made me feel that way. But your lifestyle, I mean, the sports and the dancing and no sleep. I just, it's too much for me. I mean, I love your company. But I think that you and I are set at very different speeds.
So, that's it? Really?
Yeah, I think it has to be.
It was pretty great.
It was really great.
Good luck.
Bray, hold all my calls for an hour.
Munchkins here somewhere?
Huh? Oh, no, they kicked me out of the gang.
What happened?
Well, they're playing this prank and tried to stop it.
You stopped a prank.
Yeah, so now I'm out of my ass.
You actually acted your age? Good for you.
What do you mean?
Well, you actually did the normal grown-up thing instead of your usual M.O.
Yeah. Yeah, I acted my age. Pretty cool, huh?
You might even think about trying it full time.
Yeah, Kenny. Maybe so. Fuck you, you killed me. Take that, you son of a bitch. I'll see you later.
It was hard watching him take down the big Isaakland sign. I was gonna take it with me, but they broke it. And I didn't want a big sign that just said Ackland. That only confused people.
The sale is final?
Yeah, this German consortium bought it. I took a loss, but not too bad. They'll take care of the place. After all, who knows more about having lighthearted fun than the Germans?
How's Gretchen?
Gretchen's moving on. You know, she had some trust issues that came up after her son was booked for criminal mischief at my establishment. So I lost the theme park and I lost the girl. But I think every guy goes through that.
It's a good thing you already had one.
One what?
Playland.
I just told you I sold Playland.
Not that one.
Well, that's the only one that I have.
Think about it.
Yeah. Yeah, if you'll excuse me, I think I'll get back up there.
Well,
Robert Culp gave me this.
Wow, very nice. It must be serious.
Actually, we just broke up.
Oh, sorry about that.
Cotton candy.
Uh-huh. God bless the Germans for letting me take it.
Yeah, well, they don't understand cotton candy like we do.
No, they don't. No, not at all. You okay?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, actually, we had a pretty great breakup.
Uh-huh.
You know, that's the thing about dating a mature person. You have a mature breakup. That's a milestone for me.
Yeah, you know, I had a kind of a milestone about the whole Playland thing.
Really?
Yeah, I realized that you can't recreate your childhood, but that's okay because there's a lot to be said for grown-up fun.
Thanks.
Next Chris Isaak Show. Where can you see the biggest musical guests, the craziest redhead, and the rock star whose mother approved? Only on the season finale of The Chris Isaak Show. With an all-star lineup that's gonna bring down the house. Kathy Griffin, Green Day, Everclear, The Goo Goo Dolls, and more. It's the season finale of The Chris Isaak Show. Next Tuesday at 10.
Log on to sho.com now to hear more great music from the rock star next door, Chris Isaak.